Click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ikeda.
Hello friends, in this lecture we are going to study the Okumura model. This model was developed by Okumura, who measured the transmission and the reception power and then plotted the graph upon which we are now able to find out the path loss. So the radio transmission in the mobile communication takes over an irregular terrain. The terrain profile of a particular area needs to be taken into account for estimating the path loss. The terrain profile may vary from a simple rounded earth profile or a curved earth profile to a highly mountainous profile. The presence of trees, buildings, and other obstacles must be taken into consideration while estimating the path loss. So let us see what is this Okumura model. So Okumura model is one of the most widely used models, which is used for the estimation of the received power in the urban areas. This model is applicable for the frequency that is ranging from 150 MHz to 1920 MHz in the distance of 1 km to 1000 km. It can be used for the base station's antenna that have the height from 30 meters to 1000 meters. Let us see now what is the actual Okumura model. Okumura, what he did was, he took the measurement of the received signal and then he plotted the graph. We can see here the graph in which the x-axis has got the frequency and the y-axis, we have two axes. One axis shows the distance, which is the distance between the transmitter and the receiver, whereas the second axis shows us the mean attenuation. So here, as we can see, the x-axis is the frequency. The first y-axis is the distance curve. The second y-axis is the attenuation. What I have done here is I have plotted 900 megahertz on the x-axis. So as we can see on the x-axis, we have 900 megahertz. This is plotted on a 50 kilometer curve. So this curve here is for 50 kilometer distance between the transmitter and the receiver. And when we try to find out the attenuation on this curve for 900 megahertz, that is a GSM band, we can see the attenuation comes out to 43 dB. So the attenuation at 900 megahertz for 50 kilometer distance is given as 43 decibels. I want you all to remember this number because we are going to use exactly same scenario during the numericals. Let us see the Okumura path loss equation. The Okumura path loss equation is given by L 50 dB, that is 50 means the percentile or the mean attenuation value in terms of decibels is equal to LF, which is a free space propagation path loss, plus AMU, which is nothing but the attenuation which we have just saw, plus AMU, which is nothing but the attenuation which we just saw in the graph. This is a function of frequency as well as distance. Hence, in the bracket, we have F, D. Minus GHTE, which is the transmitter antenna gain, minus GHRE, which is the receiver antenna gain, minus G area. G area is the correction factor depending on the different types of areas. Please remember, we have multiple areas. For say example, we have suburban areas, then we have open areas. So the correction factor will keep on changing for different types of areas. The gain of the antennas is given as G of HTE. Remember, this is strictly a function of the height of the antenna. So G of HTE for the antenna height between 30 meters to 1000 meters is given as 20 log of HTE upon 200. GHRE for antenna height, that is a receiving antenna height less than 3 meters, is given as 10 log of HRE upon 10. 10 log of HRE upon 3. Finally, the receiving antenna height for antennas that have height between 3 meters to 10 meters is given as 20 log of HRE upon 3. So remember, the gain of the antenna heights is strictly the function of the height of the antenna. Finally, we come to the correction factor or the G area. We can see here on the x-axis we have the frequency, whereas on the y-axis we have the correction factor. We have three curves. These three curves represent different types of areas. The first curve represents the suburban area. Then we have the open quasi area. And finally, we have the open area. So from these three curves, depending on the scenario, we can find out the G area. For now, I have plotted for 900 megahertz, that is a GSM frequency band, on the suburban area. We can find that the G area factor comes out to 9 decibels. So again, please remember these figures. It will be required during the numericals. So the Okumura model is completely based on the measured data. It is not a predefined equation or an analytical equation. So Okumura has measured this practically and then plotted the graphs. So the Okumura model is considered to be the simplest and the best model in terms of the accuracy prediction for the path loss. It is a very practical model and it has become a standard for system planning of land mobile communication in Japan. There is one disadvantage of this Okumura model. The major disadvantage of the Okumura model is the slow response to the rapidly changing terrain. Hence, this Okumura model is not suited for the rural areas, whereas it is suited for the suburban as well as the urban areas. Now, let us see at the numerical of the Okumura model. So, the question here is, find the median path loss using the Okumura's model. For D is equal to 50 kilometers, HTE or the transmitter antenna height is equal to 100 meters, HRE is 10 meters in the suburban environment. If the base station transmitter radiates an EIRP of 1 kilowatts at a carrier frequency of 900 megahertz, find EIRP in dBm and the power at the receiver, where the gain at the receiver antenna is 10 dB. Let us first write down the given information. So following is the given information to us. Let us see what I've been asked to find out. So the very first thing that we have to find out is the path loss using the Okumura model. So let us write down the equation of finding the path loss. So the equation is given as L50 dB is equal to LF, that is the free space path loss, plus A mu, that is the attenuation, median attenuation, minus GHRE, minus GHTE, minus G area. So first our requirement is to find out LF. So the LF is given by the formula. Minus 10 log of lambda square upon 4 pi square into d square. Lambda here is given as C by F. So this equation turns out to minus 10 log of lambda is nothing but C by F. So we have put the values of C by F over here. which is the whole square. Then we have upon 4 pi the whole square into d square. D here is 50 kilometers, hence in terms of meters it is written as 50 into 10 raised to 3 the whole square. This value turns out to 125.5 dB. Let us find out other values that are required for the Okumura path loss model, that is a median attenuation. So median attenuation, that is a function of distance and frequency. Distance here is 50 kilometers. And the frequency here used is 900 megahertz. So if we go back to the graph, we can easily find out that using this 50 kilometers and 900 megahertz, we had plotted the value of AMU, which came out to 43 dB. Similarly, let us find out the other parameters, that is GHTE. GHTE is given by 20 log of HTE upon 200. This formula comes from the fact that the value of HTE is 100 meters. So the value comes out to minus 6 dB. Let us find out GHRE. This comes out to 20 log of 10 upon 3. Final value turns out to 10.46 dB. Let us first rewrite the equation and then we'll put all the numerical values. The free space path loss is given as 125.5 dB. The value of AMU is given as 43 dB. The value of GHRE is minus 10.46. The value of HTE is given as minus of minus 6. The value of G area is given as 9 dB. Remember, we have plotted the graph in which we have seen the G area having three curves. Here the question says we have to find it for the suburban area. So for suburban area at 900 megahertz, we have seen the value of correction factor G area as 9 dB. So this entire value turns out to 155.04 dB. So this is the path loss that we have calculated using the Okumura model. Let's move on to the second part of the question. We have to find out the EIRP in dBm. This is given by the formula. That is 10 log of EIRP divided by milliwatts. So the EIRP that we have here is 10 watts. The EIRP that we have here is 1 kilowatts. So the value turns out to 60 dBm. Finally, we have been asked to find out the median received power, where the antenna gain is given as 10 dB. So this is given by the formula EIRP in dBm minus L 50 dB plus the antenna gain. So the answer here turns out to minus 85.04 dBm. So this is how we have solved the numerical on the Okumura model. Thank you so much for watching this video. Stay tuned to Ikeda and subscribe to Ikeda.